Hello, friends. It's Allison. Just coming back to you to give you a debt update on where we're at September. So stay tuned. Whoop. Okay, welcome back. So this month has not been as momentous as the last several months. And that's because I swear I am always talking about this, but my husband and I, we have another truck repair that I'm saving up for. So I have not been able to put all of the money that I want on our debt this month. So I thought I would go over where we started for the beginning of September and see where we're at for this whole month. So in the beginning of September, I'm really focusing on paying off our very last credit card, and then we will move on to a personal loan. I originally had my plan that I was going to pay off this last credit card and then pay off this private student loan, but I've decided I'm not going to do that because I looked at the interest rate and I want to get this personal loan off my books, okay? More on interest rate in a bit. But so I'm focusing on this last credit card. And at the beginning of September, I owed $8,473 on this card. And as of today, we are down to $5,461. So that is $3,000 difference. So that's exciting. So paid off that $3,000 in that. So that was the big, that's like been the big focus with this past month. So I started with at the beginning of the month with a total, I still have that personal loan and I had $31,512 on it. It's now down to $30,878. And then I had my student loans, which totaled up to, I had my $13,817 loan, and then Dave's student loans of $21,951, and then my other student loans of $79,836. So that gave us a whopping total at the beginning of September. We were in $155,589 in the hole. So as of today, though, as you guys know, student loan repayment has started. I have opted to not use the government consolidation and to just use the loan servicer consolidation. And so I'm doing a graduated extended payment. And then basically what we're going to do is we're going to pay off our current credit card, then the personal loan for the $30,000, and then we're going to hit the student loans. And how I'm going to do that is I'm going to do a debt avalanche with them, and I have them all broken down. Let me show you here. I have it already all written out of the loan name, the balance on the loan, the interest rate, and then I actually have the monthly payments broken down because they have them in for my student loan servicer. So I thought that was kind of nice, but that's going to be my strategy for the student loans. So basically currently as of today, on my last credit card, I've got $5,461 left to pay on that. The Upstart loan, we have $30,878. And so that leaves us with the consumer debt minus the student loans at $36,339. And then our student loans, starting today, are at $115,934. So that gives us a total of $152,273. So for the month of September, we paid off $3,316. You guys, I am very happy with that. We've also saved up money for my husband's truck repair, which is going to be between $4,000 and $5,000. So my paychecks are going toward that right now. And so, yeah, like, I mean, all of this is coming together. Something that I definitely noticed is in the middle of the month, we had paid off a lot more debt than what this final number had been for for September. However, the interest hit our student loans this month. And it also hit that personal loan as well that we're paying off. And so it dips into that debt snowball, or not the debt snowball, that debt that you've already paid off. So that is something that you guys seeing that student loan interest hit my student loans was like, oh, ouch. Like it hurt. And it actually is extremely motivating to just get this done, just to get this absolutely done. So with my current Bank of America, the last credit card I have to pay off with the $5,400 on it, I am thinking that it's gonna take me about 2 months to pay off. Actually, I might be able to get it paid off this month. We'll see, we'll see. Stay tuned, get excited. It's working out. But with just Christmas coming and everything and us continuing to cash flow everything, I want to be realistic and honest. But you know what? I actually think I could have it paid off by the end of October here. If not, definitely right at the beginning of November. So stay tuned on that. And then we'll be hitting this personal loan super hard. This personal loan of the $30,000 is going to be a hard, I'm just kind of anticipating this to be a little bit tricky, because when you're paying off this big lump, you know, $30,000, it's just going to be kind of a long haul of wanting to move on to something else. So it's going to personally push me in my personal development and focus, just to stay really on that and chip away at it. So I'm kind of thinking about how I want to just stay motivated with that. One of the things that I did do, and I think I shared this in my last video, is I did bust out this star, Reaching for the Stars payoff tracker. I got this printout from the Budget Mom. She's on YouTube as well. She teaches all about like budget and financing and everything. So I printed this off as one of her printables. And so I've been using that. So that's been pretty motivating to be able to mark this off and mark the stars off. So that's going to be something I'm going to do to help kind of get through this long haul of paying that off. And then I thought I would also just kind of like right now, I owe $30,878 on that personal loan. And so once I dip into the next decade, that's going to be exciting. And then once I get below the $25,000 mark, that's going to be probably pretty exciting as well. So anyway, we've got that. But first things first, gotta pay off this final credit card, which is going to be so exciting to do. So that's September for you guys. How are you guys doing on your journeys? Let me know in the comments. Please like and subscribe. What's going on here? One of my little covers was coming off. Like, subscribe, let me know how you guys are doing and how the journey is going for you guys. And let me know what else that you guys want me to talk about as well. Obviously, the updates are very motivating. I love watching all of you as well who are going through the debt journey. I always am watching the videos just to stay motivated and on top of things, maybe learn something new. And so anyway, that's what's going on there. But until next time, we will see you soon. Stay curious.